Hey everyone, Johnny B here with Devslopes.com, and I am super excited to teach you all about Mapbox. Mapbox is an incredible framework that allows you to build experiences for exploring the world. As a developer, working with user location can be difficult, but with Mapbox, it is a lot easier to add location services into any application with their mapping, navigation, and location search SDKs. There is so much that Mapbox can do for you. It supports iOS, Android, Web, Unity, and Qt out of the box. So let's take a look at the app that we are going to build in this series. I got it open right here, and it shows our location, which I have set to San Francisco. And when I tap anywhere on the map, it goes ahead and drops a marker and overlays the best route to that location. And then when you're ready to get going, all you gotta do is click on Start Navigation, and we will begin turn by turn directions. And you can choose to have those turn by turn directions muted or not. You can also click here to report any issues, such as road closures or bad routes. And this information goes straight to Mapbox to improve their maps over time. All right, so this is, you know, pretty snazzy. And you may be thinking, wow, this looks like a lot of work. But it's really not using Mapbox, all right? So let's get started and hope you guys are excited because this is gonna be a lot of fun. All right, so I have here a pretty much brand new Android Studio project. In this series, we are using Android Studio version 3.1.2. And this series, we are using Java, okay? So we also have a series using Kotlin. So if you want to use Kotlin, go ahead and switch over to that series. Now I've gone ahead and added a few dependencies and some other things. So let's go ahead and go over that real quick. So open your build.gradle and go ahead and add these two dependencies right here. We're gonna start with the Android SDK, and that is currently at version 6.0.1. We are also going to be using the plugin location layer, which is currently at 0.5.0. If you're watching these videos in the future and these have updates, go ahead and update to the latest version. Now, if you try to run that and get this crash, go ahead and also add this little bit of code here for our compile options. This is simply setting the source and target compatibility. Also, in your project build.gradle file, under the repositories, make sure you have added Maven Central. Next up, to use Mapbox, we are going to need our API key. And if you haven't already gotten that, go ahead and sign up at mapbox.com. It's super easy, free, and grab your API key. And then we are going to open up our values folder here under resources, go to strings.xml, and you can just add a new string resource called access token and go ahead and paste your access token API key right there. And then we're gonna go over to colors here, and this is optional, but if you want to go ahead and make your app a little bit more themed like the Mapbox colors, you can go ahead and modify your colors to match what I have here. I have the Mapbox blue set as the primary and accent colors, and then we also have a Mapbox white, blue, and gray light color. So you can go ahead and pause this now if you want and copy those hex values. Lastly, since we are going to be using user's location, we are going to need some permissions here in the Android manifest.xml file. So go ahead and right here, do uses permission, and the one we want is access fine location. Okay, you can also use course location, but find location is strongly recommended as that will give your user the most accuracy. So with that, we are now ready to add in our map to our XML, all right? So go ahead and go down to our resources and layout and grab our activity main.xml. We're gonna be here in the text editor. I'm gonna get rid of this text view here, and we're going to go ahead and import our map view. So you want com.mapbox.mapboxsdk.maps.mapview. We're gonna go ahead and go with match parent and match parent, get rid of this window. And then I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this closing here and just go ahead and self-close right here. All right, so we have now added in a map view. I'm gonna go ahead and change this namespace here from app to map box. There we go. And so now we need to give our map view some properties. So if you think about it, a map, what do you need? Well, you need to know where you are. So let's go ahead and add a camera target latitude and longitude so that when we launch our map, we are looking at a specific location. And I'm gonna go ahead and put in the latitude and longitude for San Francisco. So the way to do that is to say mapbox colon mapbox underscore camera target lat, so a target latitude, which we are going to do 37.7749, and then our mapbox colon mapbox underscore camera target longitude, LNG, and that is equal to minus 122.4194. And then we have the option to be able to style our map in a specific way. So we have several that are available to us by default, and the way to add that is to say mapbox colon mapbox underscore style URL. And this is equal to mapbox colon slash slash styles slash mapbox. And then this is where you would specify. The one we're going to start out with is called streets dash V10, okay? And then lastly, we are going to set a zoom level, okay? So I'm gonna say mapbox colon mapbox underscore camera zoom. And we're gonna set that equal to 12. And that's a pretty good zoom level for not being too close, but also not being too far away. You can go ahead and experiment with that value and find one that fits your preferences. All right, so we have added our map view widget. We've set the width and height to match parent. We've set a target latitude and longitude. We've given it a style and a zoom level. So last thing that we need to do is go ahead and jump into our main activity and create a map view variable. So I'm gonna say private of type map view, and we're gonna name it map view. And then down here, first thing we're gonna do actually is give Mapbox the information that it needs, being the application context and our access token. So I'm gonna say mapbox.getInstance. And so here we are going to pass in the context and the access token. So I'm gonna say get string, and we're gonna say r.string.access token. So now Mapbox has the context and our access token. It can do what it needs to. And now let's go ahead and get our map view. So I'm gonna say map view is equal to, it is of type map view, and we're gonna say find view by ID, and we are gonna say r.id.map view, and I think we forgot to give it an ID, so let's go ahead and jump back into our activity main.xml over here, and let's say Android ID is equal to map view. There we go. So now that error should go away just like that. And to get started, we need to say map view dot on create and pass in the saved instance state. All right, so the map view contains its own lifecycle methods for managing Android's OpenGL lifecycle, which must be called directly from the containing activity. So in order for our app to correctly call the map view's lifecycle methods, we need to override the activity's lifecycle methods and add the map view's corresponding lifecycle method here. So here in onCreate, we did mapView.onCreate. We're also going to need to do the same thing in onStart, and say mapView.onStart, as well as all of the others. So hang tight, we are going to add those real quick here. So here we go. I'm gonna say onResume, and that is mapView.onResume. Then we have onPause, so mapView.onPause. I'm gonna go ahead and get some room right here. There we go. We're gonna say onStop. And so we're going to say mapView.onStop. Then we have onSaveInstanceState. So I'm going to say mapview.onSave instance state and pass in the out state. Then we have onLowMemory. So we're going to say mapView.onLowMemory. And lastly, finally, onDestroy. So mapView.onDestroy. There we go. So now our mapView has access to all of the necessary activity life cycles. So now let's go ahead and run this and check out our map. All right, and there's our map of San Francisco. Looking pretty great. You can zoom in, zoom out, you can rotate. You can do a lot of stuff with the map right out of the box. Now, before we finish up this video, I just wanted to show you real quick some of the other styles available to you. So we talked about that here in activity main.xml. Here's our styles. So streets-v10 is one of them, but another one that you can do is dark-v9 for a kind of a dark theme. So I'm going to go ahead and run that. All right, check that out. That looks fantastic. A nice dark theme. So if it's nighttime, then you can dynamically change the style for your user. So that's pretty cool. All right, the last one that I want to show you is we have traffic-day-v2. There's also a traffic-night-v2. So I'm going to run that. All right, and that shows us, wow, the heavy traffic in San Francisco right now. So pretty cool. So as you can see, there is a lot of stuff that you can do with Mapbox right out of the box. And so this is super exciting. In the next lesson, we are going to do some even cooler stuff using the user's location. So hope you're excited for that, and I will see you in the next one.